Hello and welcome back. In the previous videos, we were using the continuous time Fourier transform to do a spectral analysis of signals, giving a signal, finding the spectrum, the frequency content of the signal. And if you recall, effectively to find the spectrum as a function of the continuous function of mega, if we had a continuous time signal for which we have a mathematical expression, meaning an x of t, we just computed this Fourier transform integral. Right? So, a continuous time signal, you plug it in, and you get the spectrum. We also mentioned that any continuous time signal for which we have the mathematical expression can be plugged into this equation, including periodic ones. Okay? You just will have spectral lines that are impulses, but we have defined the impulse function. So we are good. This is our spectrum analyzer, a very useful tool. Plug the signal in, get the spectrum out as a function of continuous omega. Okay, so the next question is, can we use our spectrum analyzer, our mathematical spectrum analyzer, to better understand not only signals, that is what we have been using, x of t is a signal, but also systems? Could we use it to find the frequency response of a system, for instance, right? And so you could think, well, we have been right now on a block diagram, we have been denoting these systems, like these LTI systems, as a block. It's almost like we wanted to plug the block here in our integral to get the frequency response out, right, of the signal, of the system. The question is there a way to apply the continuous time Fourier transform not only to signals, for which we have been applying, the signal gives you the spectrum, but also to systems? If the system is LTI, linear time invariant, then the answer is yes. Well, you may ask, well, Mateo, how can that be? You mentioned that for the continuous time Fourier transform, we needed to have a signal with a mathematical expression that we plug into the integral. How are we going to plug this block? The answer is, and you recall from when we last studied some systems, is that there is one signal that completely characterizes the system, meaning there is a signal here. Think of it as the DNA of the system. Think of it as the fingerprint, whatever. But there is a signal that completely characterizes the system. And what is that signal? The impulse response. If you recall, you go ahead, and we have that LTI system. If we put a delta in, and we measure the response of the system when the input is an impulse, if it is a continuous time system, a Dirac delta impulse, so you put an impulse, you measure your system, we call that the impulse response. That's going to be a signal. Maybe something like this, which we denote as h of t. And that signal, think of it as the DNA of the system, or the signature of the system. It's a signal that completely characterizes the system. We are going to see that later. It tells you everything that you need to know about the LTI system. Okay? Meaning you can find the output for any other input signal, not just the delta, as long as you know h of t. And we can find the frequency response. More importantly, now we have a signal here, okay, it's a function of time, that we could plug in right into our Fourier integral. in our continuous time Fourier transform in order to do a spectrum analysis. Is that clear? Let's recap for a second. We have the continuous time Fourier transform. It allows us to do a spectral analysis of signals. We have been using it to understand the spectrum of signals. We would like to use it now to understand systems. Can we put a block diagram in? No. How do we use the continuous time Fourier transform? You need a signal that is continuous time and for which you have a mathematical expression. As it turns out, if you put a delta into an LTI system, you get a response, you get an output. And that response we call the impulse response. The output when the input is an impulse. So input, impulse. Output, impulse response. This signal, now we are going to be able to plug it in. And so our frequency response of a continuous time signal is going to be the Fourier transform of the impulse response. So not only we can use the continuous time Fourier transform to find the spectrum of signals and to do signal analysis, but we can also use it to find the frequency content, the frequency response of systems, meaning how a system is going to behave as a function of frequency or for signals of different frequencies. Is it going to be a low pass filter, a high pass filter, a band pass filter, a band stop filter, right? And we do that, and we answer all those questions as long as we know one signal, which is the output of the system right here when the input is an impulse, or the impulse response. So this is the central idea of this chapter, the response of LTI systems, the fact that the frequency response of a LTI system is the continuous time Fourier of a continuous, the frequency response of a continuous time LTI system is the continuous time Fourier transform of the impulse response. Or briefly, the frequency response of an LTI system is the Fourier transform of the impulse response. That allows us to discuss filters. And the other thing that is important here is the fact that this impulse response that we have been talking about is a complete characterization of the system. Of course, at the very minimum, you get the frequency response. But if it is a complete characterization, even in the time domain, you should be able to find the output for any other input. And that is what the convolution integral allows you to do. If you know the impulse response of a system, you can find the output for any other input, not only impulses. And then, once you add some structure to your system, right? Like if a system does not have any structure, stability, what you can say about stability, whether the system is stable or not, is a bounded input, bounded output. Meaning if you have a bounded input, is the output bounded? But you can never prove the stability of a general system. Okay? If you add some structure, like the system is linear and time invariant, then the impulse response h of t also allows you to quickly test stability and causality. Okay? So a fundamental idea in this chapter is h of t, the impulse response. It's the central idea. With impulse response, we're going to find y of t for any other input, x of t, by convolving it with impulse response. So you can find the outputs in the time domain. You can also, which is easier, find the outputs in the frequency domain. Well, you're going to find the spectrum, meaning the frequency response. With impulse response, you plug it into the, you do the Fourier transform of the impulse response and you find the frequency response. If you know the frequency response, you can also find the output as h of j omega times the Fourier transform of the input. So, you pick an input, you find the Fourier transform of the input, meaning you find the spectrum, and you're going to multiply the spectrum times the frequency response to find the output. And then you can also do the inverse Fourier transform to go from here to here. And it's going to allow us to check whether the system is stable and also causal. Quickly. Again, what is the impulse response? The response of the system when the input is an impulse. You put an impulse in, into your system, and you see how the system responds. You see the output. That y of t, meaning x of t, your input is a delta. Your y of t, the output, is the impulse response. We give it a name, h of t. So, delta in, measure what the output is going to be, h of t, and with that, we are able to do all sorts of things, right? Find the output in the time domain, convolution. Find the frequency response. What is the frequency response? The Fourier transform of the impulse response. By the way, in this case, because the system is continuous time, it will be the continuous time Fourier transform of the impulse response. If the system was a discrete time, the discrete time Fourier transform of the impulse response. If it's a digital system, where we have digitized, we will use the digital Fourier transform, the discrete Fourier transform, and we will do this efficiently with an algorithm, which is the fast Fourier transform. But again, the idea, you have an impulse response. This is a signal that you can put in the Fourier integral to find the frequency response, how the system responds to signals of different frequency, or how it responds as a function of frequency. Meaning, is this, if we plot as a function of frequency, something that looks like a low-pass filter? This is the magnitude. Or is it a high-pass filter? That's what you're able to find with this signal. It's really cool. So you put the simplest signal in, so to speak, a delta. You measure the frequency response. Sorry, you measure the impulse response. You're able to find the frequency response. You're able to find it directly in the time domain with convolution. You're able to find the output, the spectrum of the output, by multiplying the frequency response times the spectrum of the input signal. And we are able to look at whether it's stable and causal. We will also look at more properties of the continuous time Fourier transform. So that's the objective for in this playlist. And this is the key idea. The impulse response as a complete characterization, not of all systems, but yes, of LTI, linear time invariant systems. Everything we want to know, as you can see here, the output for any other input, the frequency response, stability, causality, all that we can find with the impulse response. Thank you.